As you near the end of pregnancy, you'll hear new terms like effacement and dilation from your care team. These words can sound intimidating, but understanding them helps you feel more prepared and empowered. Think of this as your body's way of signaling that birth is approaching. The final trimester is a time of anticipation. Your body is making its final preparations for your baby's arrival. Effacement and dilation aren't about predicting the exact moment labor will start, but about appreciating the steps your body is taking. Knowledge replaces uncertainty with understanding and fear with awe. Every pregnancy is unique, and your body knows what to do. There's no race, just a remarkable process unfolding in its own time. We'll break down these concepts simply so you can feel more connected and at ease. Take a deep breath and let go of pressure about progress. You are strong, capable, and getting ready to meet your baby. Let's begin this journey of understanding together. Before birth, let's meet the cervix, a small, strong passage at the bottom of your uterus. For months, it's stayed closed and firm, protecting your baby. It's the silent gatekeeper holding everything in place and blocking bacteria with a mucus plug. As your due date nears, hormones and your baby's pressure prompt the cervix to transform. It must soften thin and open to allow birth. This shift is what effacement and dilation are all about. The cervix isn't passive. It's an active participant in pregnancy and birth. Your body's timing is wise. Slow progress is still progress. The first big change is effacement, the cervix thinning and shortening. Imagine your cervix like the neck of a turtleneck sweater. As labor nears, it stretches and thins so your baby can pass through. Effacement is measured in percentages, from 0% thick to 100% paper thin. 50% means your cervix is half as thick as before, an encouraging sign. At 100%, it's fully thinned out, ready for birth. Effacement happens at its own pace, sometimes over days or weeks, especially for first-time parents. You might be partially effaced before feeling strong contractions. For some, effacement and dilation happen together, especially in later pregnancies. There's no right timeline, just your body's unique preparation. Trust the process as your body gets ready for birth. While effacement thins the cervix, dilation is the opening. Dilation is measured in centimeters, from 0, closed, to 10, fully open. Early labor is 2-3 centimeters active. Labor starts around 6. 10 centimeters means your baby can be born. To visualize 1 centimeter is a Cheerio, 4 centimeters a cracker, 10 centimeters a bagel. Progress isn't always steady. You might stay at a few centimeters for hours, then suddenly move quickly. This is normal. Your body is building momentum. Don't stress about the numbers or timelines. Each centimeter is a milestone, bringing you closer to meeting your baby. Focus on coping with contractions and conserving energy. Trust your body's rhythm. The opening act is underway. Effacement and dilation are partners in labor's dance. Effacement thins and softens the cervix, dilation opens it. For first-time parents, effacement often comes first, sometimes over days or weeks. Once thinned, dilation usually progresses more steadily. In later pregnancies, both can happen together, making labor faster. But every birth is unique. There's no universal pattern. Don't get caught up in numbers or comparisons. Your body isn't on a schedule, it's following its own wisdom. Whether effacement leads or both progress together, trust your process. Your care team monitors these changes for safety. The numbers are just snapshots, not predictions. Your provider checks effacement and dilation with a gentle cervical exam. They use gloved fingers to feel the cervix's position, softness, thinness, and opening. This quick check gives a snapshot of your body's readiness. Cervical checks are helpful, but they can't predict exactly when labor will start. You can choose how often to have these exams. Discuss your preferences with your provider. Some want frequent updates, others prefer fewer checks. Open communication is key. Your comfort and emotional well-being matter as much as physical progress. You're in control of your care. The most important message: your journey is unique and your body is wise. There's no standard timeline. Some progress slowly, others quickly. Embrace the unpredictability and let go of outside expectations. Your body and baby are working together on their own schedule. Celebrate every sign of progress, no matter how small. If things seem slow, remember your body is doing what it needs. Focus on what you can control, ask questions, stay informed, and practice relaxation. Stay calm. Your mind and body work best together. Keep in close contact with your care team. They're your guides and support. Trust their expertise and your own instincts. You're on the threshold of something incredible. Be gentle with yourself and trust in your body's ability. You are ready for this amazing journey. If you find this video interesting, click the playlist on the screen for more intriguing pregnancy videos.